Hi, I'm Thilinu Deiratne from Pulse.lk, and I'm here at the Hilton Colombo Hotel. As you can see behind me, the name says it all. I'm here at the third day of Colombo Fashion Week. It has been 3 days, like I mentioned earlier. Today happens to be the third day, and today happens to be the showcasing of the menswear segment. And right now, I'm at the corridor of the Hilton Colombo Hotel, and it's absolutely crowded over here. Lots of representatives from different countries and different parts of the country as well. And we're just hoping to stay back for a while, and let's just go talk to some people and see how this evening is turning out to be. Hi there, I'm here at the Hilton Colombo, and it's the Colombo Fashion Week. It happens to be the third day here today, and where the showcase is mainly focused on menswear. And it's currently going well, and we have two people here right with me. Can we first have your good names, please?
I'm Imra.
I'm Shibli.
All right, so now we saw a range of clothing today, and how is the evening so far?
Really good. It's nice to see menswear for a change that is being displayed. On a different realm, instead of getting mixed up with women's clothing, yeah? So we have a descriptive idea of what designers want men to wear for the first time.
And how might your opinion be on this?
Well, I'll just say it's the same thing in the context of not only the design in terms of men or women or whatnot, but I think it's a fantastic opportunity for us, our Sri Lankan folk, to sort of showcase their talent as well. And I think this has been going on for I don't know how many years, but it's phenomenal for our young talented designers to come out there and showcase their clothes. And also you know, it's kind of a breeding ground for folks to get into the fashion industry, which is really was limited to a sort of a niche a bunch of guys or gals or whatever the case may be. So I think it's a good opportunity for the young kids, as well as old people like me. Maybe I'll get into fashion designing after I've seen what. I'm just kidding. But the truth is, it is good. It's a good thing, and I think it's a positive thing for the fashion industry, and also from a business perspective. I believe it's a good thing. It gives a lot of mileage with Sri Lanka within the different Fashion Week destinations. You've got a bunch of international artists coming, sharing their talent, their expertise, and our guys are learning more and more, and they're also given the opportunity to showcase. So, thumbs up. Two thumbs up, actually.
All right. So now, coming back to tonight, we saw a range of clothing tonight. Any particular favorites, any particulars that you want to, that really caught your attention tonight?
I would say, what I would say is, make a difference for us Sri Lankan men to like fashion, because we are more like trousers and shirt and a tie. What our fashion designers today did was, it's more than that. And you still can be a man as long as you have a good damn shirt on.
And I'm just going to...
Ditto that, because my fashion is designed by my wife. Otherwise, I'll be in a pair of shorts and a t-shirt. But true to the cause. I think it's giving everybody... And today's world, I see young guys. When I was 21, we were 22, 23, I don't know, in the early 20s, we were not too concerned about how we looked, how we dressed. We were kind of all shabby. But today I see the young executives, they are more concerned about how they look. Their grooming is spectacular. They're going to the salons. They're doing facials, man. I didn't do a facial till I was 35 or something like that.
Times have changed, isn't it?
So it's all good. It's all good. And thanks a lot for having us on your
Definitely. Show. Thank you so much for joining with us, and we hope to see you, and we hope you enjoy tonight. We have with us one of the fashion designers who've been showcasing her talents today. Can we have your good name, please?
I'm Shanika Samarakode.
Right, okay. So you being a fashion designer yourself, and how would you feel about tonight's performance, tonight's gala event?
I actually feel proud about myself and very encouraged because this is my first time on the main show. After 2 years of struggle, being on the main show is fabulous.
All right. So in particular now, we ourselves saw some of these attire, some of the outfits. Any particular interests that really grabbed your attention, your eye, that really caught your attention?
I actually like Saman's collection, and it's actually very elegant, even though it's menswear. I personally really liked it. I love the colors, I love the whole, like the badges and everything. I totally like it.
Fantastic. Okay, just one last question now. Now, this sort of thing is somewhat new to Sri Lanka, if I'm not mistaken. But you being a fashion designer yourself, how would you feel, and what would be the message that you have to give to the society of Sri Lanka in general?
Be trendy. Just don't stick to whatever you wear day to day. Just grab your phone, smartphone, go online, check for the trends and colors, what you need to wear, and then just being a woman and doing menswear is not that easy, but I take it as a challenge, and it's really interesting, like designing for men, what I want to see, what men can wear, and I think Sri Lankan guys, they're actually getting up to that stage where they're getting trendy and stylish, so I'm hoping to see more.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for joining us for the interview. We hope to see you soon, and enjoy the rest of the evening. Once again, we'd like to mention that it's the third day of the Colombo Fashion Week, where the showcase is mainly focused on menswear, and we happen to be backstage of Hilton Colombo. It's absolutely fantastic, something absolutely amazing to see. So keep stay tuned with us. We have more updates coming your way. Hi there, my name is Thilin Udayaratna from Pulse.lk, and I'm here at the Hilton Colombo from Colombo Fashion Week. It's the third day and I have with me someone, and first of all, can we have your good name, please?
I'm Lochani.
Right, so my first question would be, how exactly has the night been so far?
Oh, it has been a very enjoyable one so far. I enjoyed yesterday as well because it was a women's collection. Today was also interesting, something different, men's collection. I enjoyed that too, yes.
Fantastic. Okay. Now, you saw a range of different clothing today, a range of fashion outfits, all of that. But any interest in particular, anything that really caught your attention tonight?
Look, I'm not a big, critic about men's wear because I prefer the ladies' wear collections. But Gihan did an interesting thing this week, I thought. Gihan was my favorite.
Right, okay. Now, Colombo Fashion Week has been happening for 13 years, and we sincerely hope that it would continue for more years. And any final message that you want to give out, as in general, to the how do you want to see the future of the Sri Lankan fashion industry?
Well, I would like to see more new designers coming in, because we have been seeing the few regular ones, and I do love all their things, but I would like to see more new talents coming in.
Fantastic. Thank you for joining us. It's a pleasure interviewing you. We hope to see you. I hope you have a good evening as well. Thank you. I'm at Colombo Fashion Week, coming to you from the Hilton Colombo, and I happen to be backstage right now, and I managed to come across a volunteer who's been volunteering for Colombo Fashion Week. Can we have your name, please?
Vinuri.
All right, so Vinuri, now you're a volunteer. I just want to know, how is the whole volunteering experience been for you for Colombo Fashion Week?
It's tough, but it's good.
It's tough, but it's good. All right, so do you have any connections to fashion designing at all, or just is it something that you just came across?
No, I study fashion marketing, so yes, through that and through friends, I got to know about this.
All right, so fantastic. Now, how has the volunteering experience today and all this has been so far?
Been very good so far, yes.
Okay, she's a bit too excited, but she managed to get through it. All right, so we're here backstage at the Hilton Colombo, and this is Colombo Fashion Week. It's the third day, so yeah, we'll bring more updates as we go on. Hi there, I'm at the Colombo Fashion Week, and it's the third day, it's the menswear day, and I'm here coming to you from the Colombo, I'm here coming to you from the Hilton Colombo, and I have with me someone who's here to share her opinions. First of all, can we have your good name, please?
I'm Melissa Dharmadasa.
All right, so my first question to you would be, now you saw a wide range of clothing tonight, how has the night been so far?
It's been good. This was the first menswear section that I've day that I've actually been for Colombo Fashion Week, and I think it was quite good. The first was like the opening act was by far my favorite. So yeah.
Okay. So considering that tonight was your favorite from the seven from the days that you've seen.
To be honest, today is the first day I came for, so I'll be here tomorrow as well. And out of all the days. And out of all the designers, Indy was my favorite so far, so...
Okay, so that was my question to you next, but you answered that already. Any final words to the... Now, Colombo Fashion Week has been happening for 13 years, and this is the 13th time. So, any final message that you want to give out to the all the youngsters out there, all the young aspiring fashion designers out there?
Let's see. Well, I think the bottom line is you gotta do what... you want to do in your life, and if fashion is the way that you want to go, well, I think you should just go ahead and do it. So
well, there you have it. That's a fine piece of message. Thank you so much for joining with us. Hope you enjoy the rest of the evening. I'm coming to you from Colombo Fashion Week. It's the third day, and I'm here at the lobby of the Colombo Hilton. And I have with me someone who's ready to share her opinions. And first of all, I'd like to ask you, what's your name?
Tasha Fernando.
Right. Okay. So I just got to know that you performed yesterday. You went on the ramp yesterday, and you'll be going on the ramp tomorrow as well. So how has the whole fashion, as in the showcasing experience, been?
Well, my debut in like modeling was basically Colombo Fashion Week last year. So this is actually my third show. And I can tell you one thing, it's given me a great deal of confidence. As in, I'm like a completely different person after modeling, and it just boosts your confidence a lot. So that's what I can say, like, to all girls who want to, I don't know, model, guys too, just do it. It'll give you so much confidence. Yeah.
All right, so just do it. And coming back to tonight, and how has the show been so far? Did you enjoy tonight's menswear segment? How has it been so far?
It was great, and especially because I've been backstage, I know the amount of chaos that is going on. But when you see them calmly walking on the ramp, we don't know what's actually going on backstage. There's a lot of chaos and craziness. So, but it was nice to see all my friends on the ramp. It was great. The collections were amazing.
Fantastic. One last question. Any particular message that you want to give out to the local fashion industry?
Basically, don't think that just go out and don't be scared. Do it. Don't be intimidated by people telling you that you can't do it, like, oh, Sri Lanka can't do modeling here, but just go and do it. Go, just do it, basically, just do it. Because I did it, and I was really scared before I started. I didn't think I could do it. I went for it. Now it's my third show for CFW, and it's great. It's great. So.
Well, there you have it, folks. A story from youngster herself. She has been here for a couple of years. And thank you so much for joining us for an interview. We hope to see you soon, and hope you have a good evening as well.
Thank you. Thanks.